Hello and Namaskar. Welcome to another session of BW Farhana Tidbits, where I share some of my knowledge and experience.
My name is Devanshu Mukherjee, and today we are going to discuss LSA++ Simplified. So LSA++ is the recommended and the advanced architectural framework for BW Farhana modeling. But there have been a lot of confusion regarding how many layers are there, which layers we should model, which layers we should not. And to simplify this and to explain it in a very simple way, we will discuss today the three layers of LSA++. Yes, you're right. Only three layers are there, as simple as that. The first one is the staging layer. We'll look at that. The second one is the data warehousing layer. We'll see what goes inside that. And the final one is virtual data mart layer. So without any further ado, let's dive into it. All right. So now let's look at the LSA++ architecture with respect to BW Farhana. So let's go through this diagram, which will clearly tell you in a very simplified way how many layers are there in LSA++ and what layer talks to which layer. So let's start from the bottom, where we have our S/4HANA as a source. There you have different data sources. Here I've shown, for example, sales, FI, PM, etc. The data sources in turn take the data from base tables, but now the new data sources are based on CDS views. So starting from there, the data moves into our BW Farhana system, and this BW Farhana system now has different layers. So let's talk about that. So the first layer in the LSA++ is called staging layer, also known as corporate memory layer, also known as OpenODS layer. This can be a persistent layer, meaning your ADSOs, which will store the data, or you can also keep it purely virtual via OpenODS view. So there are a lot of blogs, a lot of material on LSA++, but they all use different terminologies. The terminology is not consistent. Some of them will use this layer and they will name it as staging layer. Some of them will call it as corporate memory. Some of them will call it as OpenODS layer. So don't get confused. It's one and the same layer. It's basically either persistent via your ADSOs or virtual via your OpenODS view. And because we are using OpenODS view, it is also sometimes called OpenODS layer. But they're all talking about the first layer, which is your staging layer. Then from there, we have the second layer as integrated data warehousing layer, where you will have your standard ADSOs and your data mart ADSOs. So in the first layer, you will have staging ADSOs. And in the second layer, which is integrated data warehousing layer, you will have either your standard or your data mart or your both types of ADSOs. And then the third layer in the LSA++ is called virtual data mart layer, which is primarily composed of composite provider. And on top of that, definitely you will have your BW queries, which will be your Eclipse based queries. And then they will be based on the composite provider. Now, if you have virtualized staging layer, virtualized first layer, you can have OpenODS views. And then again, you have a choice of using them either in composite provider or directly in the BW query. Now, one thing you should take a note of here is that it is not necessary that your first layer, which is your staging layer, which is comprising of the staging ADSOs, actually is the source for the integrated data warehousing layer. That's not necessary. Of course, you can have that, but what the SAP standard flow recommends is to have a parallel flow. So there are two flows in parallel. So for example, if you take this SD sales, we have one flow from the data source coming and sitting in the staging ADSO, which is primarily field based, by the way. Okay, you don't have info objects usually. Info objects will be there in the data mart or your standard ADSOs. So here you will have your flow and the flow stops here. Okay, the regular daily weekly flow will not have data going from the staging ADSO to your integrated data warehousing ADSO. Instead, there's a parallel flow again directly from the data source. It will come to info source, so first level of transformation, and then via info source, the second level of transformation, it goes to your integrated data warehousing layer. So that means the primary purpose of this staging layer corporate memory ADSO is not to serve on a daily basis to your second layer, but basically act as a 1:1 source data unchanged format, so that in future, if there's a problem in your integrated data warehousing layer, the user reports corrupted data or missing data, and you have to rebuild this particular ADSO or rebuild a portion of this ADSO, you don't have to go back to your source. you can take the data directly from the staging layer ADSO. So that's why there's a dotted line, meaning it's not used on a regular daily flow. The daily flow stops here and the parallel flow goes into the integrated data warehousing layer. But in exceptional scenarios, you can get the data again from your staging layer ADSOs. That's the primary purpose. And third layer, of course, is your virtual layer, which does not store data, but it's a composite provider based layer. So there are only three layers, just keep in mind. Layer number one, staging, also known as corporate memory, also known as open ODS layer. Second is your integrated data warehousing layer. InfoSource is also a part of integrated data warehousing layer. And your third one is your virtual data mart layer. And then if you scroll a little bit up, you have your reporting layer, of course, which is outside the BW4HANA. So queries the BW4HANA modeling stops. And these are your reporting tools, which can be SAP tools like SAC for cloud, business objects toolset for on-premise like Lumira, Webby, etc. And then analysis for Office Excel based SAP tool. And then you can also have your third party tools such as Tableau, Power BI, Qlik, Cognos, etc. So if you just keep this diagram in mind, you will not be confused with LSA++ architecture, and you can define and develop your BW4HANA flows confidently. Thank you for watching. I hope this clarified a lot of confusion and a lot of insights it gave you in order for you to develop LSA++ better. I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.